Fear no evil, for my God is real. The mountains are gone, amen. I think we better shout to the Lord now.
Power and majesty, praise to
You're my Savior.
Lord, there is none like you. Lord, all of my days, I want to praise the wonders of
You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great.
Call hump day. I call it booster shot of the Holy Ghost day. Okay? This is what we call our hour of power. It's nice to see so many have come out this evening. If you did not get your calendar for the new year, may I suggest that you pick one up before you leave this evening, because it gives all of the things that are happening throughout the month so you can compare on your calendar. And we're coming up on this end of this week. And the men's meeting, of course, will be at 9 o'clock in the morning, where they're having breakfast. And most men bring a dish, or, you know, the wives make things and bring things, and they have a chance to have food and fellowship with each other and the Lord. So if you gentlemen know someone that is struggling or going through some challenges, invite them out for breakfast. Bring them here. It's the best restaurant in town. He gets food for his body and food for his spirit all together, and doesn't cost anything. We always ask, though, when you do go into the Hebrews Cafe, that if you have a little change, just put it in the box for us so that we can continue to have some things for you to have on Wednesday nights and Sundays, and that we can keep paper products flowing, because when you start adding it up, paper is expensive, okay? And then, of course, in the evening on Saturday, Brother Sam has changed his club, His Hop, to Saturday evening at 7 p.m. And there is also going to be, is it going to be the play this coming? Yes, the play is going to be prior to the 7 p.m. service, and it's called Misery Loves Company. And how many of you know who Steve Harvey is? Okay, well, Steve Harvey is has one of his proteges that will be playing. This will be a live stage play. So we have the Smith Center, and we have the Art Center. And here is $25, and it's going to be a blessed program for you to watch. Bring a friend, bring some neighbors, come out and see the program, then have them stay for the Club His Hop service, which immediately follows the play. So it's a nice Saturday evening out if you want to bring some friends out in the Art Center in the next building. If you need any more information, you can see Brother Sam after service. And then next Saturday, ladies, is our women's post-Christmas get-together. And the 21st, Saturday the 21st, and it's going to be a Christmas party at Rose Conrad's home. If you don't know or need directions, see Pastor D or one of us. We have some address books that will give you her actual address. She's just really up the street. But it's a wonderful time. And one of the things that they've asked each lady to bring is a Christmas ornament. Okay, so each time we bring like a little gift, but you bring a Christmas ornament. But her home is beautiful, and it's always decorated for Christmas. And it's just a wonderful time for all of us ladies to get together and have a wonderful celebration. You know, you can make Christmas move right on into January and February, whatever. You know, but it's great. And of course, we still have our healing schools and on Monday, as well as prayer and our Wednesday evening services. And our Women of WOW usually have their Wednesday morning program. So that's all that's in here. Of course, remember, if you are thinking about classes that are available on Sunday morning, the Book of James is still being taught. And also the Serving God class has already begun with Dr. Ruth, and that's in Classroom 3. So you can sign up if you want to check in with Dr. Ruth to see it start. Both of these classes start at 9 o'clock, and they end in enough time for you to make it to 10:30 service. Okay. I keep thinking about, I've been seeing a lot of things as I watch and read in my Bible studies about putting God first in your life. And since you're starting out a new year and you're starting out with a clean slate, make him a priority. Make him a priority with everything that you do. You know, sometimes we make decisions to do things on our own and we didn't check in with him about it. And then we find ourselves knee deep in a mess or something, and he'll help you through it. But why go through it at all? Make him first. And make him first in everything. In your prayer time in the morning, start out your day. Don't leave your house without talking to him, because you have no idea what's outside the door. You know, so make him first. And make him first in your tithes and offerings. Try to make that a part of your monthly budget, that he's included and the first guy on the list, instead of when I get finished paying all of this, then I'll take care of it. Wrong way. Him first, and it'll help you to work through the 90%. So we're going to take a look at 2 Corinthians 9, 6 through 7. Remember this, he who sows sparingly or grudgingly will also reap grudgingly and sparingly, sparingly and grudgingly. And he who sows generously, and that blessing shall come to someone else, will also reap generously and with blessings. God doesn't need our money, but there are people out here that do. People that need a church like this to function so that they have a place to come without persecution, so they can have a place to get answers. And the only way this church is going to work is when we, its family, keep it flowing. Let each one give as he has made up in his own mind and purposed in his heart, not reluctantly or sorrowfully, or under compulsion. For God loves, that is, he takes pleasure in, prizes above other things, and is unwilling to do without a cheerful, joyous, prompt to do it giver whose heart is in his giving. Can the church say amen? God is pleased with our giving. So when you came in this evening, we have envelopes. And the reason we ask for you to have envelopes, it's so that at the end of each year, there's a recording of how much you've given. And this helps you to get ahead. You know, you can, you know, church is considered a charitable donation. So you can keep records of your donations and watch how you flow. And sometimes we don't forget, you have your checkbook. Sometimes you give cash. But this way you can kind of see and keep a record. So use these envelopes that have been given for you to use. And so we're going to lift up our tithes and offerings. You can either put your tithe and offering in an envelope, make it out to your checks out to Family Worship Christian Church, FWCC. You can use our debit card machine and credit card machine if you wish to do it that way. Or, if you'd like, you can also pay your tithes and offerings online, which is LasVegasChurch.org. So why don't we all lift up our tithes and offerings vehicles? Let's thank you, Father, for all the blessings that you're doing for us. You're showing us how to give as you gave us Jesus. And we're just using our token of love and affection for you by giving in your church. And we're expecting an abundant return on our blessing. In Jesus' name, amen.
Spider-Man movie. Remember they had this guy called Doc Ock? We got to get a few more hands welded on Maurice so we can do a little more. The Lord is good, isn't he? A couple things. If you haven't checked in yet to the church, if you're on Facebook, please do that. Say something nice. Also, if you haven't sent me a friend request, please do that. I think you'll like me. And then also, we have our year-end giving receipts, our tax receipts, and so we have them right over here. So if you would mind picking them up from me after church, after the service tonight, that way we don't have to mail them to you. I know stamps are like 50 cents. A piece almost, you know, I don't know what they are, but they're almost 50. So, you know, you do enough of them, you can save a little money here and there, and we can use it to spread the gospel rather than give it to the post office. Amen. And so anyway, if you do that, we just have something for you to sign to say you received it, and so on and so forth. And so I think we're good. Amen. I believe we have our men's meeting this week, our men's breakfast here. And of course, we know we have His Hop on Saturday night. So for those that want to stay out late, amen. Well, you know, we've been talking about the subject of faith and confession and what Christianity is and what it isn't. We said, you know, a couple weeks ago, we said confessing is actually three things. It's confessing, stating something that we believe. It's declaring something that we know to be true, and it's proclaiming a truth we've accepted wholeheartedly. Some of the things that are to come out of our mouth is what God has done for us in Christ through His plan of salvation. So we talk a lot, you know, here about who we are in Christ. And somebody once said, well, why don't you teach more on the Old Testament? Well, because we live in the New. And so we use the Old for examples and different things like that. But you'll find that primarily most of our teaching here is New Testament. We're in a New Testament church. And so, but we do, of course, use the Old Testament as well to give us certain examples and stuff. So Let's look at, if we could tonight, 2 Corinthians, if you would, with me tonight. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. And we'll just read a few things here. It's getting kind of warm in here. I don't know if it's... You know, I called my son yesterday, and he said they were having a snowstorm in Minnesota. And I thought to myself, yeah, that's a good place to be from. Are you going to move back there to take care of your grandkids? Let me think for a moment. No. I like it here, don't you? But even more important than that, I like being in the will of God for my life. And that's the most important thing, isn't it? That we're all in the will of God for our life. We're going to talk about that on Sunday. I want to talk to you a little bit more. And we started out talking about last Sunday on decision making and, you know, how Jesus made decisions. And, well, we actually talked on Sunday how he didn't make certain decisions, certain criteria not to use. But we're going to talk about this Sunday how he did make decisions and then how we can make decisions too. Because we want to make wise decisions, don't we? Especially as we get older, isn't that right? Because you know what you find as you get older, you don't have as much time to fix your screw-ups. Right? You know, I remember my dad used to tell me when I was a young guy, and he was an older guy, he said, you know, son, he said, there's no fool like an old fool. I do not want to be an old fool. I want to be an old wise man, or somebody a little bit older that knows a few things. So 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, notice what it says. It says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. That's a good word for us tonight. We could just pitch a tent on that and just embrace that scripture tonight. And it would be good for us, wouldn't it? But look at the next verse, if you would. The next verse says, in verse 18, it says, and all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and hath given unto us the ministry of reconciliation. So, you know, we could say this tonight, and we've talked about this before, but sometimes we forget things. Do you ever forget something you've been told? You know, so if we don't keep things before us, they tend to kind of evaporate, you know, through whatever you want to call it. And so God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Probably the first thing that we always need to keep in mind to every decision we make in life is this particular passage of scripture right here. He's given unto us the ministry of reconciliation. We have to ask ourselves the question, and we should ask it tonight, how is what I'm doing causing me to operate in the ministry of reconciliation? I've heard, you know, folks say this, you know, well, and I remember, you know, when I grew up on a farm out in Minnesota, out in Hicksville, and, you know, old farmers would, their whole dream would be to work their whole life, you know, to get themselves to a certain point, and then they thought they'd retire and maybe move to Florida or somewhere and go south, you know, and so they quit doing what they were doing, and soon after they quit doing what they were doing, we were all eating hot dish at their funeral. So we all need a purpose. Now, for the believer, it's even a higher purpose, because you have the purpose of the ministry of reconciliation. In other words, our job is to influence the people in our sphere of influence. We all have a sphere of influence. Now you might say, well, I'm just tired of people. I don't want to be around people anymore. I just want to isolate myself, move to a mountain, you know, and well, go ahead and be out of the will of God then, but your life will be miserable. He's given unto every one of us the ministry of reconciliation. So when you go to work tomorrow morning, I want you to remember that you have a ministry of reconciliation. You're not just there to make money. Although making money is good, isn't it? Because we got to pay our bills, right? And pay our tithes. And if we can't do that, then the gospel doesn't get spread. If we don't make money and we can't pay our tithes, the rent at the church don't get paid, and the church goes away. Amen. But even more important than that is the ministry of reconciliation. It's to all those people that God has brought in. See, God's given us each our own little congregation. And it's the people that we rub shoulders with every day. Look at the next verse, if you would. So the next verse said, he says, to it, God was in the world reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them. But he's committed unto us the word of reconciliation. You know, if you came here tonight seeking God for a word, and I believe with all my heart that if you have, you'll receive that word tonight, whether it's anything I'm talking about or not. But he has already given you a word, and that's the word of reconciliation. God's not mad at you anymore. He's not imputing your sins unto you anymore. Now your job is to go out and give that to someone else. That is the good news, isn't it? That you know that we can be okay, that we don't have to walk around in condemnation anymore. I believe there's another verse, isn't there, on this one? Is there, Sammy? Pop it up if you would. He said, now, he says, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be reconciled unto God. So every one of us here tonight, you know, have been given a ministry. You might say, what is my ministry? The ministry of reconciliation. That's our first ministry. Now you see, if you don't get past that one, probably not too much more is going to be added unto you. You have to learn to influence the people in your sphere of influence. We all have the ministry of reconciliation. You might say, I want a word. What's my word? Be reconciled unto God. Give that to someone else. But he says here in this passage, he says, now then, he says, we are ambassadors for Christ. In other words, our job is to demonstrate to the world, this is good, man, what it's like in heaven, what it's going to be like. Because, you know, our citizenship is not here on planet Earth. I've said it before, but you know, on my driver's license, it says my address, and then it says Las Vegas, Nevada. But the truth is, if it was really true, my address would say Planet Heaven. Planet Heaven. Mansion on whatever drive. Mansion on Diamond Drive or Gold Drive, Planet Heaven. How about you? So he says, we're ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be reconciled unto God. So we're not poor. We're not weak. We're not staggering, barely getting along, sinning church members. We are the very righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And you come here tonight so I can remind you of that tonight. And you can leave here tonight empowered to take this message with you as you walk out these doors. And that's why it's so important that, you know, the Bible says, you know, that we forsake not the assembling of ourselves together, especially as we see that day approaching. Now, one of the ways we charge ourselves up, there's a scripture, you know, and we all know this, in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18. Let's look at that tonight if we could. Ephesians chapter 5, I believe it's verse 18. Well, that's good. Let's go to verse 18. I believe it's that one. Notice what he says. He said, don't be drunk with wine. He says, we're in excess, but he tells us here to be filled with the Spirit. In other words, we are to be recharged. I like to say it this way. There's only one infilling, but there's many refillings. Isn't that right? Look at the next verse. The next verse says in verse 19, it says, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody into your heart to the Lord. You know, I've often thought to myself this, what if we as a church body just took a day, maybe before we came to church, maybe Wednesday, all day long, all you did was speak to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, and you sang and make melody to the Lord, what kind of service do you think we'd have Wednesday night? I think it'd be kind of a long service, don't you? I think it'd be pretty powerful, don't you? Notice the next verse. He says, giving thanks always for all things. He says, unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, there's something about giving thanks. There's something about worshiping Him that it's like it energizes the Word of God in your life. It's like it energizes you. There's a scripture that tells us, you know, that praise stills the enemy. You might walk in here with all kinds of weird thoughts. Have you had any weird thoughts today? Any kind of negative thoughts about yourself or your family or somebody else? There's something about praise that just shuts that off. And then as we get into worship with Him, it's like it takes that word that was on the inside of us and it just literally energizes it. And we turn in, we go from being Clark Kent to Superman. Right there. Right in the phone booth of 1 John 1:9. Amen. Let's give thanks to Him for a moment, shall we? We give thanks with a grateful heart. We give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am weak. Because of just give You thanks tonight, Lord. We love You tonight. We thank You for Your holy word. We thank You for who You are. We worship You tonight. We worship You tonight. We love You tonight, Lord God. We worship You, Lord. Worship You. We worship You. As the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after Thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to Thank you.
You're my fortress. You're my deliverer. Will I trust? When I gaze into your loveliness, when all things that surround become shadows in the light of you, oh, I like this part. When I find the joy of reaching your heart, when my will becomes enthroned with your love, when all things that surround become shadows in the light. Worship you tonight, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, brasaba mama makasito bemenikete. Rababala basito bemenikiche. Miko bramana mesete te 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 te. Bracha makasoto mendende. Miko lobo soto brende kende. Oh, bramana memekesete. Lobro bababa basite. Oh, brasika mama ramama. For lift your hands,
saith the Lord. Lift your hands unto me. Lift your voices unto me. Lift your being unto me. Oh, for I'm alive and reign forevermore. I stand at the door and knock, let me in. Oh, stand up. Well, I got rains. Well, I got rains. Well, I got Sunday. Oh, amen. Praise the Lord. Well, we could just go on in this tonight, couldn't we? Praise the Lord is good, isn't he? We love you guys. Come back and see us on Sunday. Don't forget about the men's meeting. And please come and get your taxes from me afterwards if you wouldn't. And hey, we love you. You're dismissed.